Everything you just saw right now was created entirely using AI, from the visuals to the background music, and as you can see, it looks absolutely stunning. Remember those days when AI videos used to look like this? Fast forward just 2 years, and this is where we are now. It's getting better day by day, which makes this the perfect time to get into the AI content creation game. I'm telling you, ladies and gentlemen, AI is like the internet back in the 90s. Most of us weren't even born back then, so we couldn't take advantage of that opportunity, but now, if you don't take advantage of AI, you'll definitely regret it later. A few years ago, if I told you I created something like this using only my laptop, no one would have believed it. But today, creating something like this has become incredibly easy. In today's video, I'll show you step by step how I created this, so you can do it too. I'll show you how to choose the idea, draft the scenes, create the visuals, generate the background music, and finally, edit and put everything together. So, without wasting any more time, let's get started. Alright, we'll create the video in 5 simple steps. Step number 1, choosing the topic. Now, for the topic, you can literally choose anything you like. You can take inspiration from famous movies, or even create your own cinematic universe from scratch. For this video, I've chosen Avatar, because I absolutely love this movie, and since the new trailer just dropped recently, there's already a lot of buzz around it. That makes it the perfect topic to start with. Step number 2, creating the scene draft. I created this scene draft with the help of ChatGPT, and let me show you how you can do it too. To get good results, you need to give ChatGPT a strong prompt. So here's how you can create better prompts using ChatGPT. First, open ChatGPT and paste this prompt. Act as a prompt engineer, review this prompt and make it better for best results. Ask for any clarifications if needed, then paste your normal prompt right below it and hit generate. Don't worry, I'll give you this prompt so you can try it yourself. As you can see, ChatGPT has now enhanced the prompt for even better results. All you need to do next is copy that improved prompt, open a new chat, paste it there, and hit generate again. And here it is. As you can see, it has created a much better and more engaging scene draft. You can use it as it is, or make a few changes if you'd like to personalize it. Step number 3, generating images and videos. This is the most important step, ladies and gentlemen, because without great visuals, nothing else really matters. For the images, I'll be using Seedream 4 because in my opinion, it's simply the best. And for videos, I'll be using Seedance Pro, which is currently my favorite video generator. The results are just too good. You can use both of these models on Hugging Face for absolutely free. But keep in mind, you can only generate a limited number of images and videos there, which honestly isn't enough for creating something like this. And let's be real, you won't be able to create awesome videos like this completely for free. So, we'll be generating the images and videos using Higgsfield AI. I recently discovered this tool, and it's seriously impressive. To get started, simply click the link in the description and sign up using your email ID. After that, you'll see an interface that looks like this. As you can see, right now it's offering unlimited generations for Sora 2, Wand 2.5, Seedance Kling 2.1, Nano Banan, and Seedream 4 if you're on a subscription plan, which is just awesome. Now let's generate the images. To do that, hover over the image option and select Seedream 4 from the list. It will take you to this interface. Next, we'll give it a prompt. In the prompt section, I'll paste this prompt for the first scene. And by the way, I've created a detailed document containing all the prompts for the images, videos, music, and everything else you'll need to make the video. Just comment guide and I'll share it with you. Now, let's change the aspect ratio from here. And finally, make sure you turn on the unlimited option. Otherwise, it will deduct your credits. Then just click generate. And here's the output. Wow! Folks, just look at this result. It looks absolutely stunning. It completely nailed the cinematic vibe I was going for. It literally looks like a scene straight out of the Avatar movie, doesn't it? This is exactly why Seedream 4 is my favorite image generator right now. Let's generate the image for the second scene. I'll paste this prompt and hit generate. And here's the output. I honestly have no words. You guys be the judge. I'm telling you, no other AI image generator can match this quality. Not even Midjourney or Flux, and trust me, I've tried them all. finally, all you need to do is create the images for each of your scenes one by one. And if you don't like a result, no worries, just regenerate it as many times as you want, since this plan is completely unlimited. Once you're done with all the images, it's time to turn them into videos. Let's do it. Hover over the video section and choose Seedance Pro. This is the video interface. First, you need to upload your image here. I've uploaded the image for the first scene. Now let's give it a prompt. I'll use a very simple one, because with Seedance, the simpler the prompt, the better the results. Also, make sure you turn on the unlimited option here as well, otherwise it will deduct credits. Once that's done, hit generate, and here's the output. Wow, folks, just look at this. The video looks absolutely stunning. It was able to scan every detail from the image and beautifully turn those elements into motion. Look at the clouds, the waterfalls, everything looks so natural with no distortions at all. It truly feels like a real scene from the Avatar movie. And guess what? We did this not with Kling, not with VO3, but with Seedance, which is pretty amazing. Let's try one more. This time I've uploaded this image, added this prompt, and hit generate, and here's the output. As expected, the result is awesome. I'm telling you guys, you won't fully understand how good this is until you actually try it yourself. Now just turn every single image into a video one by one. And remember, you get unlimited generations, so don't stop until you get the perfect result. Step number four, background music. For the background music, I'll be using Suno. To open it, just click the link in the description and sign up using your email. Suno will give you 50 free credits to generate music. From here, click on Create. Now you can directly enter your prompt and generate tracks, but if you want even better results, go to the Custom option and write your music styles there. I'll paste these styles based on my topic and then hit Generate. It doesn't take much time to generate the music, and here are the outputs. Let's play one to test it. Wow, that was absolutely soul-touching, guys. I honestly didn't expect it to be this good. It fits perfectly with my video because it has that tribal vibe I was looking for. Step number five, editing. I'll be using CapCut to edit the video because it's super easy to use, but you can use any video editor of your choice. First, open CapCut and import all your video clips and background music. Now drag and drop the background music into the timeline first. Next, let's add the video clips one by one into the timeline according to the scene draft. I'm also adjusting the duration of each clip based on the background music, which is why I added the music first. Once that's done, let's add transitions between scenes. To do that, go to the Transitions tab and search for Black Fade. Simply drag and drop it between your clips. It's that easy. You can also adjust the duration of the transition from here. Now add transitions for your other clips as well, but don't overdo it. Just add them wherever you feel they enhance the flow. I'm personally using only one type of transition, but you can try others too. Just make sure to keep them simple and clean. Next, let's add some text to make it look more professional. To add text, click on the text section and drag a new text field into the timeline. Now adjust the position. I want to add the title text at the end, so I'll place it here and adjust the duration accordingly. Now let's write the movie title here first from this text box, then change the font from here. As you can see, there are plenty of options available. I'll go with this one because it's the same font used in the first Avatar movie. Now, to add a glowing effect, scroll down and turn on the glow option, then adjust the intensity as needed. Next, adjust the size and position, and our text is ready. You can also copy and paste this text, change the content, and add it between clips if you want. It makes the video look even more professional. Once that's done, let's add some filters to make it more visually appealing. To add a filter, go to the filter section, choose the one you like, drag and drop it into the timeline, and extend it to cover the entire video. You can also adjust the filter intensity from here. I'll set it to this level. And finally, our video is ready to export. Click on export, give it a name, choose your desired quality, and hit export again. And here is the final result. Wow, that was absolutely stunning, wasn't it? And now, you can do it too! I was able to make this within just a few hours, so imagine the kind of content you can create with a little bit of effort and creativity. So go ahead and start creating your awesome content now. And if you face any issues, let me know in the comments. I'll be more than happy to help. If you found this video useful, make sure to like, share, and subscribe to support the channel. Thank you so much for watching, and as always, keep grinding.